Snagit users, I have wonderful news. Snagit 2025 is out, and it has an incredible feature that I know I'm going to use probably every day. We've always had the option in the Snagit editor to do steps. So let me show you this real quick in case you didn't know you had this. Then I'm going to pop into steps inside of the capture window. So I have a screenshot already in my Snagit editor, and I'm making this up. Someone says, Chris, I don't know how to change the font color in Excel. Easy example, but I'm going to hit more and I'm going to hit steps. I've been playing with this, so it wants to do number 3 and I don't want number 3. I'm going to hit restart. So now it'll be number 1 and I'm going to click, and there is number 1 to click on home. And number 2 would be to click on the font color, the letter A. You can change these over here. If I say, okay, I don't like number 2 looking like this, I want it to look this one here, just change it, and now I'd put this right there. That is steps. We've had that for the last few versions, I believe. At least I know it was in 2024 and 2023. What you can do now, go select your capture window. My capture window's on the screen. Let me put this in Excel just to keep this simple. This is me. I'm usually on image, and I'm usually also on region. This is where I like to normally work, so I do most of my screenshots here. The new feature that you have in 2025 Snagit is a steps capture. When I select steps, what it will do is every time I start clicking, it'll record number 1 I click somewhere, number 2 I click somewhere else. If you're on a web portal and you type your name, instead of saying click, it'll say type name here, and it'll still number it, number whatever. So let's see how this works. I'm just going to move this off to my other screen, and then I am going to click on capture just to be clear about this. So here we go. Here's my example right now. Let me do a quick sort. Somebody sent me this file, a coworker, and the coworker asked, Chris, I need to sort by state, then by city, and then by income, largest to smallest. How do I do that? Most likely, they're going to start off on the home tab. So here you go. I'm clicking the word capture, or doing my keyboard shortcut for capture right now. It pops onto your screen, capturing steps. The capture steps toolbar shows up in the bottom left corner. You can move this anywhere you want to, including, just to be clear about this, another monitor if you have a second monitor. The icons you have are to pause the recording, stop the recording. I haven't done any clicks or type, so it says 0 steps. I can restart this, and I can cancel out of here also. So, the steps to record. By the way, I just clicked into Excel, and it says 1 step. I'm going to show you how to delete that one because I really don't need that one. The steps to do a multiple sort are data. I'm going to click data. That became step 2. I'm going to click sort. That is step 3. You don't see it, but it's doing screenshots in the back. The sort order that they asked for was state, A to Z, add level. So every time I click, I get a step in here. City, add level, income, and here comes a click over here to the right. They said they wanted the income largest to smallest, and then I got to click on OK. So I have 14 steps recorded, or 14 clicks. And once again, if you had to type somewhere, it would include the typing. By the way, it did work. If you look at California for San Diego, Marietta first, then San Diego, then San Francisco. Look at San Diego, 85,000 over 55,000. It's working. I'm done. I'm going to select stop. When you click stop, just like with Snagit, the editor is going to open up. If you recall, I started off by clicking in my Excel file. So it recorded this as step 1, and it says click here. Step 2 is click on data. Well, step 2 is actually the first step. Watch how easy this is. Over here to the right is delete. Before I delete this, I want to show you this. If you need to move stuff up or down, I'm going to hit move down just to prove this works. So now data is the first step, and this step that I really don't need is step 2. Just to prove you can move it back up, let's do a move up. But I really want to delete it. I'm just showing you that the move works. So let's hit delete. Watch how cool this is. Now data is step 1, and that's where I need to start off with, clicking on data. So not only can you move these sections in here, like step one is a section. If I wanted to, I could widen it or shrink it down, no problem. In case you're wondering, Chris, why would you want to do that? Maybe I need to widen it a little bit and I could throw in a text box with some instructions down here if I wanted to. Great feature right there. Also, these images, make sure, by the way, I still got step selected, so let me just go to selection. If I click on an image, I can shrink the image down, and then I can hit the plus sign. So plus and minus, shrink down, shrink up, great feature. If I needed to manually swap an image, notice it says drag to swap. I could drag another image in here and replace it if I wanted to manually do a screenshot myself. You can also double click inside this image, and you can see the screenshot that it did and what it's doing right here. So in case it was wrong, you can move this around, but it's been very accurate while I've been testing this. Just click outside of here. So there's my step one. I'm gonna run through this quickly. Step one, step two was to click on sort. Step three, I hit the drop down and picked income. No, I'm sorry. Step three, I hit the drop down and then I clicked on state. So I may, in real life, I would probably get rid of this. Let me delete that section here. So now I eliminated a step. So now I'm clicking and picking state. Then I'm adding a level. Again, I don't really need this one. I'm going to delete that one. Pick city. Probably get rid of that previous one, by the way, too. And then one more time, let's get rid of this one. So step seven, I want to select income. And then you can see over here that I'm selecting largest to smallest. Let's get rid of that step. There we go. And then I click on OK. So I went from 14 steps down to 8 steps in this example. And now you go, Chris, now what are you going to do with this? First of all, up at the top, before I do anything with it, you can get rid of this. It's just a text box. Delete that. Do I want this over here? No. Windows Explorer is the name of this. That's a horrible name. Let's name this Excel Steps to Do a Multiple Field Sort. That sounds good. Change that name to whatever you want to. You can change the font color and all that, just like you do in Snagit. Now, I could share this if I wanted to over here to the far right, multiple places to share to. I would probably turn this into a PDF. Oh, before I turn into a PDF, you can select these. And if you want to select multiple ones, hold down the shift key, keep clicking. And if you don't like these, you can come change them over here the same way you would change steps anyway. I'm happy with these though. File, I want to make it a PDF. You could print it. That was file print. I want to do a save as, file save as. I'm going to select PDF. I'm going to change the name. I'm going to leave it that for now and hit save. You're saying, Chris, that looks horrible. Well, yeah, I'm still in Snagit and it went and made it 10%, just to be clear about this. These images will show up. I know you're saying, Chris, that looks like a bug. Give it a second and the images will pop in here. While I'm waiting for these images to pop in, let me go pull up that PDF file just to show you how it looks. So here is the PDF file that got created. Looks really, really good. I am a huge fan of this already. Back in Snagit, here it is. Everything showed back up, just to be clear about that also. I'm Chris Menard. Hope you enjoyed this video. Big fan of Snagit. It's one of my favorite tools. Thank you for your time. My online training classes are listed down below. Have a great day.